Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Lines and Lead. Gonna shake things up a little bit for you today. Had some folks wanting us to do a catch and cook, so that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna go out, see if we can't get us a catfish in the boat, and then we're gonna take him somewhere and we're gonna skin him out, fillet him, trim him up, and go ahead and get him in the grease and get him cooking, see how we do. We got a couple of testers in the boat today. Brandon Harris. Everybody knows Brandon. And Big Cat Hunter Williams is on the camera today. And so if they eat a whole bunch of catfish and grin a whole lot, you'll know we did a good job. And if they're over in the bushes and weeds and gagging and a hacking, you know we didn't do such a good job. So we appreciate you coming along. Y'all stay tuned. All right, you got any hook?
We got
one. This might be supper, Brandon.
All right.
You're bending your rod.
Oh,
he's off.
Oh.
Hang on, that's okay. Hang on.
Oh man, how did that come off?
Down the piss to deck. There he is. Oh, he's on there now. All right, Brandon, come here and get this rod. You got him? Now don't pull the nut back. He's got the rope. I'm just going to go in easy.
Okay.
Bless God.
See, are you controlling that rod? Because it's moving.
No, that's... Bless God. Hang on, Mr. Catfish. Hang on, Mr. Flathead. Now, Brandon. We can get it in his mouth. Well... That wasn't what we was trying. That hole was so small. How does a fish that size get in a freaking hole
that's awesome.
That size? Bless God. Hey, he hit it like a champ. Look how he bent that hook.
I see that.
All right, folks. That is a good North Carolina flathead. Look at there, where he beats that head on that concrete when he gets pissed. Ooh, he gets mad. Hey,
look at that.
You can run that rod in there, and he'll go to thumping. I mean, just to thumping on that old. And you can hear him. And they get agitated and angry. Look at that fish, that's a good fish. Bless the Lord. I don't know what he weighs, but I believe he's a little bigger than one. CJ caught.
If not the same size.
Weight wise.
Yeah.
I mean, feels heavier, but that was a while back, so.
That's a good fish. Yeah. Open that mouth.
Open that mouth. Talk to him, son. I couldn't get him.
That's a good one there.
He had his head in that hole, and son, he was a jerking and a pulling, yeah, and right. I was trying to get my hand in his mouth, and I couldn't, and that's why I was trying to ease him out just a little, and then he decided he was just going to make a break for it.
It's
here
like
he comes.
Put the parking brakes on them.
You know what I didn't bring again today? The scales. Folks, I'm serious. I meant to bring the scales so that we could weigh these fish for you and give you an accurate idea. And so I'm gonna try to be generous. And I'm not the king flathead fisherman of the world, but I'm gonna tell you, that fish probably weighs 22 pounds, somewhere in that range. He's a good or no, bless God. We're gonna throw him in the boat, snap a few photos. I don't want to cook a fish this big. For the three of us, I'd like to have us one about, 8-10 pound range. But we'll take a few pictures of him and we'll see if we can't find us another one to cut up. Putting oil, amen. So y'all just stay tuned, bless God. Brandon, I felt a thump. He's in there?
Got him.
All right. slide over there with him, Brandon, and help him work the man the rod and let Hunter. Now remember, at the end of that rope is that treble hook. Hey, get your left hand behind his gill and your right hand in his mouth, and that way he can't roll, because when he comes out, he's gonna go to spinning. All right. Here he comes. Look at here. Look at here, son. Yeah, he gonna spin. He gonna spin.
Got that treble hook in my finger.
Does he? Need me to help you?
No, we got him.
You got him? All right. Brando, let me hold the pole and you help Hunter. There he is.
Oh, maybe that's why I was grabbing him something.
He's down.
He'll spin that hand around. Right, there you go. Don't let him loose. All right. Bless God. Oh yeah, he choked it. Brandon, come a little closer with it. All right, suck that back in. Hunter.
Yeah.
Had a baby. I'd fist bump you, but bless God, you got your hands full. Well, hold that bird up, let's see him.
Well, he's pouring the blood.
That's right, hook was on top of his mouth. Hey, oh! I believe that's eating size, boys.
Think so?
Yeah. He probably 10 pounds. That's the range we're hunting. So turn him sideways. Ain't nothing wrong with that fish. Ain't nothing wrong with that fish at all, baby. All right. Good deal. Good deal. Ha ha. Atta boy. That hook up on top of his mouth. Don't lose him, Brad.
And 100% sure some of that blood wasn't mine.
Flathead here that we called a little while ago. We've run across the lake to the island here, and so the first thing we're gonna do, we got him hung up in the tree.
That we caught?
That Hunter caught. This is a Hunter fish, and you can tell it's a Hunter fish by the size of its mouth. Amen. Anyways, we've run across the lake here, and we've got this thing hung up. First thing you're gonna do, cut his tail off. And let that bird bleed out. So, we'll let that old blood run out of him. Alrighty. After he's bled out good, all we're gonna do is come right behind. You can feel there's a bone there, and it runs around that fish. And all we're gonna do is we're gonna go right around there with our knife and split that skin. Ooh, look at the water running out of him. We're gonna come right up here to his backbone, and we're just gonna go straight down this backbone. Now we're not doing nothing but just splitting the skin on him and running it all the way down. And the sharper your knife, the better. Praise the Lord. On around that fish and get you a finger hold where you can get in there. It helps just a little bit. Let me get my claws here. Yes, I know these are wire strippers, but the ends grip really good to hold the skin of that fish. So y'all laugh all you want here in a second. I'll show you how good that works. Somebody needs to sponsor me some good knives, bless God. Down here we can get on that belly meat. Some people cut them up higher. That's fine if you want to. Take them right on back around to this side. We're gonna do the same thing. Just gonna find that bone. Just come right across it. Cross that bone. Just go straight down to the other cut. Now we under that skin. All right. Now, with said wire strippers, get your good holt on that skin. That meat's a rolling off of him just like it is, bless God. Just roll that hide back off that catfish. Now remember, catfish ain't got scales. He's got skin. So if you deer hunt, amen, and you ought to, this is just like skinning a deer. You're just working that skin down is all you're doing. And you get a hold of it, give it a good yank, and bring that skin right on down off of him there. Alrighty. Now that you got all the skin off of him, you just start on in there. And you can feel them ribs in that fish. And so I don't exactly know how to explain this to you. I take that fillet knife and I just run right down through yonder. Like I'm pulling tenderloin out of a deer. And I get in there against them ribs, like I said, and you can feel them. And I just start working that meat out. And there again, I don't know how to explain it other than it's just like working a deer, working the tenderloin out of a deer. You can go right down them ribs and you can feel every bit of that. And that meat will just roll right out of there. There's you a big old chunk. I'm gonna show you something. Well, I'll wait till we get it over here to work it up to show you, bless God. Come on, let's go to the cutting board. All right, now that you got him on the cutting board, Hunter will get in here. There's a vein, there's a streak runs down these catfish. And that is undesirable. You don't want that vein, that streak in him. You wanna cut that out. All I do is lay that fillet knife right down through yonder. And I just come down right one side of it. And I take that piece off. And I just lay on the other side of that vein. If you lose a little bit of meat, you lose a little bit of that meat. If you don't get it all, that's okay. You can come right back and cut in just a little deeper and get it all the next time. You're just going to throw that out there to the fish. Any of these real red dark spots, we'd rather not have. So right here, that looks pretty good to me. And that's what we're gonna cut up, just like your deer tenderloin, bless God, into little chunks. And that's what we're gonna roll in flour. And that's what we're gonna throw into that hot oil here in just a minute. So we're gonna go ahead and just trim a little bit on him. And you, it's like chicken, just trim it up however you suits you, bless God. If it don't bother you, go on and eat it. I think it tastes better without it. So I trim it off. I like a nice, pretty trimmed up piece of meat. But like I said, if it don't bother you, and you say, well, I don't bother nothing, well, bless God, just have at her and go ahead and get right in there and and do it like you want to do it. God knows I'm not the leading authority in catfish. See how clean and pretty that is there? You say, what? Well, that old boy, he wastes half that catfish cutting all that out. Well, maybe I do. But like I say, that's just kind of what I like. And you don't have to. All right. We're going to go get the other fillet out of this thing. Pull that belly meat off. And we're going to go ahead and set up. Get the oil hot. And while the oil's heating up, we'll start chunking these up and getting them ready to go in. So we'll see you in just a second. I like Zatarain's, I know. I like all kinds. But if they's a favorite, if they's a go-to, if they's a gator, which kind do you want? It's bring me house auction. Bless God. That's just the best fish breeder on this catfish that they is. It's just, praise God, it's good. I mean good. All right, everybody, the oil's hot. We're gonna just take that fish. Bless God. Drop it in this house altar. Let's just shake her up. No need to get too fancy. Woo! Watch it when it hits that oil. All right. We got that fish in that hot oil. We cut ours pretty thin. I just like my fish thin, the way I am. I like my fillets thin. It don't take them long in that hot oil to cook. You don't need to leave them in there 10 or 15 minutes. We put them in there for 3 or 4 minutes, and you can take your tongs and stick in there, and you can check them, and you can kind of tell when they're about done. There's several pieces in there, the thinner variety that's about ready to come out. And that's all we're doing. Just a little bit of house haltry. Throw them in that hot oil, give them 2 or 3 minutes each, and roll them around a little bit. Pull them out, let them cool down, and keep on getting it, bless God. So we're going to give them just a second. We're going to drop a few more chunks in the house altar and be shaking it up. So when that comes out, we got some ready to go right back in. Woo! Golden brown, we're going to start pulling it out. All right, folks, there it is. We caught it, and we cleaned it, and we cooked it. Bless God, we just got through eating it. I don't know if Hunter got any footage of us.
I was busy.
Scarfing it down. Yeah, he was kind of busy. He was eating about as hard as we was. I'm gonna tell you what, that's pretty good eating. Catfish and huffs, puppies and them taters. And especially when you're out on the water and you get to take a little break and pull over here and sit down in the shade and just watch the world go by. And it, awful good way to live today, amen. So just glad everybody's tuned in. Appreciate you stopping by and watching us. And as always, we want to take a few minutes here and give God some glory and just thank Him for everything He does. We try to remember just how blessed we are. And on my best day, I'm ungrateful. And I mean that as humbly as I can be. I just can't thank God enough for what he does for me and what he does for us. And he's been so good to me. And I don't know where you're at with the Lord. If you've never got under the precious blood of Jesus, I encourage you to do that. And, I promise you, he'll be good to you too. So if you can, drop us a comment. Tell us what you think. Let us know what we're doing suits you or not. And hit the subscribe button, like, and just let us know. So we appreciate you being with us. And we'll see you next time. God bless.